Welcome, everyone. Would everyone please rise? Going to play the national anthem of the Czech Republic and the United States. The reason we play both is because we have accreditation in both countries and because Chapman University is an American university. Officer. Nervous Radek Sobihart, Director of Research. Next to him, Honorable Chris Shallow, Chair, Department of Marketing of the
their moral and material support, we couldn't have all gathered here together today. Many thanks to all those present and to all who have supported our graduates on their journey of knowledge and education. On the way to a university degree, many pitfalls awaited our graduates, which they successfully overcame. Some were different from those faced by their predecessors. The global coronavirus pandemic and Russian aggression in Ukraine would have been considered science fiction rather than 21st century reality in Central Europe at the time they began their studies at Anglo-American University. These realities were and are a test of resilience and adaptability, not only for our students, but also a test of the creativity and flexibility of their alma mater, Anglo-American University. I hereby express my admiration and gratitude to its faculty and administrative staff, who were able to move quickly from the real world paralyzed by COVID-19 and its mutations to the virtual, digital world, which is also not immune to viruses. Think of well-known computer virus Trojan horse, or wide extension of fake news. Fortunately, this virus and misleading news only test our attention and attack our psyches, not our lives. I am confident that graduates of Anglo-American University are well prepared, not only for further postgraduate study, but also for launching a successful professional career. Our school has taught them critical thinking, the use of modern, scientifically based working methods, knowledge and skills, and has deepened their ability to distinguish correctly between good and evil. Fortunately, wherever there is evil, there is also good. The endless struggle of these opposites is illustrated by the Russian aggression in Ukraine. It has created an amazing wave of human reciprocity. Selfless help and spontaneous solidarity all over the world and especially in Europe, which is expressed in the joy of helping people affected by war. It has worked the miracle of uniting Europe, historically divided into many state formations, even more nations, and countless different interest groups against the threat from the East. Another evil we are forced to collectively confront is the rapid price growth, which we call inflation. Why do it does not attack human lives directly as a war, it reduces their quality. It humbles the rich, reduces the standard of living of the working and middle-income classes, and impoverishes the poor to the point where they have to face existential problems. Economics teaches us that nothing worse than high inflation can affect the economy and business. It is disease of the economy that distorts and obscures reality and makes it difficult, if not impossible, for entrepreneurs to make rational investment decisions. They are recipes to rid the economy of this disease, which, like a pandemic, is a global in nature. In this case, the fear will have to be coordinated, costly, and long-term. It will not be painless, but it is linked to the hope that the advanced economies will recover and the world economy will return to a path of prosperity and sustainable. I believe that all the countries and people of our planet who value humane life and are not indifferent to the fate of humanity will unite towards this goal. I am sure that our graduates, with their knowledge, abilities, and skills, will have a successful start into a professional career under these difficult circumstances and will please their families, relatives, and friends. Dear graduates, I wish you success in your professional and personal life. With your professional success in different countries all over the world, you will contribute to peaceful cooperation among nations and global prosperity. I believe that you will remain in life contact with your alma mater, because we need feedback from you for our improvement. I am sure that you will benefit from our eternal cooperation as well. I wish health and happiness to all present here. Thank you.
Thank you very much for that. Our next speaker is Honorable Bruce Denning. He's the director of the Chapman MBA program in Prague and associate professor of accounting information systems. Let's welcome Bruce Denning.
Good morning, President Schwartz. Thank you for having me. And thank you to all of the AAE staff who worked so tirelessly to put on this event. I would just like to congratulate the graduates. You're now all hotter by 1 degree, so congratulations.
Brief and sweet. Thank you. Okay, our commencement speaker is Peter Bachman. He's the chief economist at Natlin Investment Group and head of economic research at Datarun. A decade ago, he taught global political economy at AAU for 4 years. His research today concentrates on the fiscal aspects of public policy, of inflation, regulation advice, and economics in the works of Shakespeare. Sounds very interesting. Let's welcome Peter Bachman.
Congratulations, everyone, not just for the successful completion of your studies. I want to congratulate you for at least one other major achievement. You have completed most of your studies before ChatGPT was born. You're probably the last cohort to be able to say that. You should put that on your CV, you know? To remind everyone that you are still the real thing. You've actually had to work hard for your degree. Enjoy the moment of your graduation and do not worry about your team. teachers who will now, with ChatGPT, have to start making large changes to the way they teach. They will adapt, somehow. I want to take you now on a little preview of your next journey. Some people will tell you that there will be little for you to do in terms of jobs and opportunities. That you have been born to mature in an era where robots are going to steal your jobs. That there won't be any work for humans to do. First, that human manual work is already being replaced by robots. And that now that it's your turn, that human intellectual work that you have been preparing for here at Anglo-American University is going to be replaced by artificial intelligence, like that ChatGPT thing. Don't believe them. Oh, and incidentally, the same people will often also tell you that actually it does not matter that there will be any human work, since human life itself will, allegedly, be extinct on this planet before you are going to conclude your life journey. Don't believe them either, obviously. We economists, of course, believe that we have the most polished crystal balls to gaze into the future, that we are the soothsayers of our times. So let me soothe your concerns. The key word is adapt. Humans have always adapted. Somebody once invented a stone axe, and other humans had to adapt to it by adopting it. If they didn't, their productivity would decline, and with it would decline also the non-adapting humans themselves. We are all here sons and daughters of those who have successfully adapted. You of all people don't need me to lecture you on adapting. You are adept adapters, adopting the Czech Republic and its somehow sometimes strange culture as your home. You had to adapt to Czech dumplings and the holy trinity of Czech cuisine. A bit of meat, six dumplings, and the holy ghost of some ghastly sauce poured all over it. Vegetables, forget it. At most they will have been liquefied into some of that sauce. But that, by the way, is also the way our Czechs have economically adapted to the harsh winters that it used to have once upon a time. See, you have survived the Czech cuisine by adapting to its adaptations. If you can survive that, have no fear for the survival of humanity. So why am I lecturing you on adapting? Two reasons. The first, and I think your generation is very attuned to it, is what I believe you youngsters call lived experience. I have a lived experience of the same adaptations you have had to undergo. And since I am still alive, decades later, think of me as a time traveler from your future who has come to report to you that you will be just fine. Adapting to whatever life or the planet next throws at you. I too went to study abroad to a country with a strange cuisine. Except in my case, it was not dumplings, but baked beans. On toast! Imagine. As for vegetables, they don't liquefy them there, they just boil any taste out of them. In school, fish and chips were served with milk. And the ultimate horror, they put milk into even tea. I don't. Even adaptations cannot cross the boundary of human decency. Our graduation ceremony was in Latin. So just like you, I had a lived experience of promising something that don't really completely understand what incomprehensible. Further than I extended that road, you will change countries many more times in your journey. Like me. Look at me here. I eventually stumbled back to my original country, but who knows for how long? Don't just passively adapt. Actively seek out new changes of scene. Life is too short not to do so, and by changing the scenery often, you will actually make your life feel longer. Have you ever felt on a holiday that the first days feel like weeks, and the last week feels like a day? Well, in neuroscience, this is called neural adaptation. There you go, adaptation again. So, changing the country often, you will be able to live many more lives, even in the unlikely event that you don't believe in reincarnation. But I promise you a second reason for all this talk about adaptation. Economists see everything as an adaptation to changing crises, and changing crises are just an adaptation to changing environment. Nobody expressed this more clearly than the founder of our discipline, Adam Smith. You're graduating in a month when we are celebrating his 300th birthday. Adam even came in person to his birthday party that was organized 3 weeks ago in the courtyard of Anglo-American University. In honor of his native Scotland, I've been wearing this waistcoat ever since. Adam Smith showed that what makes countries rich is specialization of its people. If you concentrate on some task, you become better at doing it than if you try to create everything you need from scratch. The problem with that theory today is that things are changing so fast that you don't actually know what it is that you should specialize in. Back to our friend ChatGPT. You may have very recently thought that the safe bet for the future is to be a programmer. After all, they will be the creators of robots that will do the work of manufacturing stuff you want. But it turns out that ChatGPT is becoming better at least some programming than the programmers themselves. So whatever you have studied and whatever you want to do now, expect the unexpected. Adapt. No university could have prepared you completely for what you will actually end up doing in this constant flux. But Anglo-American has educated you for jobs that haven't been invented yet. But don't worry, the world will not run out of jobs for you to do, just like the Stone Age didn't run out of stones. New jobs will be invented and you yourselves may discover them by adapting. Humans will always find things to do. Now that we have graduated, commence the finding.
Dance number 8 by Vinohradech.
Thank you. the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Politics and Society will now be conferred upon the graduates of the School of Humanities and Social Sciences at Anglo-American University. Elfrida Maria Rubio Cáceres, El Salvador.
Thank you.
elected by the associate dean of the Barbados School of Business and Economics at Chapman University, Ruth Denning.
Enjoying the holiday atmosphere at the Christmas market in Old Town Square.
From the day we arrived, naive yet enthusiastic explorers rolling our wheeled suitcases across its cobblestone streets, Prague has welcomed us with open arms, and I'm sure many of us will be sad to say goodbye to the city we have called home for the past 7 years. But like the tight-knit community we have established that day, Prague will remain an important part of our shared identity as we embark on our individual journeys around the world. As we step into the world that awaits us, let us carry the lessons we have learned here with pride. At a time when the world seems to be divided, we should strive to be ambassadors of tolerance, unity, and mutual respect. When faced with uncertainty, we must deploy the resilience and discipline necessary to rise to the occasion. And most importantly, we should continue to seek discomfort, disprove long-held beliefs, and defy the status quo. By leveraging our unique skills and knowledge in a variety of disciplines, we can collectively address the most pressing systemic challenges in modern society. The brightest minds in business, international relations, law, journalism, visual arts, and humanities are gathered in this room, and it is our collective duty to be catalysts for change and bridge the gaps that divide humanity. Finally, I would like to take a moment to recognize the individuals who have supported me on my professional journey. I have come to understand the importance of reviewing financial statements with a discerning eye from my thesis advisor and master ceremony. Contributed to foundational knowledge that has provided a framework for success in my future career. AAU leadership, including the members of the President's Collegium and the University President, Nishi Sporch, were reliable partners in the endeavors of Student Council, an organization I'm very proud of. And to some of my best friends and colleagues who have challenged and supported me, Gia Patel, Beck Kalbakov, Hunter Vaughn, Luka Kotova, and Mariam Yatskova, I'm very grateful for your enduring friendship throughout this journey. Finally, to my family, Mom, Dad, and Beth, I would not be here without your support. I owe my successes to you. And I'm incredibly thankful that you are here with me to witness the significant milestones. From the trust you placed in me and letting me board my first international flight to the Czech Republic at age 18, from driving me to the airport to begin my internship on Wall Street at age 21, you have supported me on every step of a tumultuous journey. Without further ado, I will leave the class of 2023 with my favorite words. The harder you work, the luckier you get. We owe it to ourselves to work hard, achieve our dreams, and to leave the world more beautiful than we found it. Congratulations and best of luck, everyone.
Or you reach out to your fellow alumni who work in companies such as Google, Nike, or radio connection from now on as an alumni relations manager. And because this is the very last speech of the day, and I'm sure that you're looking forward to throwing your caps in the air, let me just finish with the most important part. In order to celebrate your achievements today, we would like to invite you all to the alumni lecture that's following the ceremony. And this will be an excellent opportunity to meet and connect with fellow alumni, have a great evening with your classmates, and learn more about the alumni community itself and what it can offer. So, there will be a barbecue as well, and I look forward to seeing you at the Vlasta Cultural Center starting from 7 p.m. tonight. So thank you very much again, and congratulations, and welcome to the alumni community.
Oh,
Thank you.